Okay? So hopefully you pay attention, and there is no big prize. I don't have iPads, I don't have iPhones, I'm like that. But hopefully you had some food there, and you had the pleasure to meet our global recruiting team there that are very anxious to talk to you. So that's going to be your prize. And I'm going to do a quick pop quiz. Vicky, you want to start?
Sure. So who can remember from our, already. 1950, one in how many U.S. population will be Latino and Hispanic?
Four.
Right?
Four. Very good. Now it gets a little bit harder. The next one is percent of Latino Hispanic population in New Jersey from 17. The 2000 census.
17.5.
17, I hear that. I hear 39 here. Any other guess?
35
on that table, and the answer is 39. This is the winner here. I'll give you mine, but it's all no with pictures. You don't want that.
So women comprise what percentage of all employees in the Fortune 500 companies?
46.
What, any other number?
54.
54? 45?
20? 45. 46. For 300 points? No. Well, the answer is? 46, I heard that on that side there. Very good. Well, the next one is a little bit harder. Women make up what percent of top earning executive officers?
10%.
Everybody pay attention to that one. All right, you know that pretty well. It is 7.6% and growing.
In our big, no double bonus or double jeopardy, but in 2020, what will be the business issue rather than an HR issue?
Diversity.
Diversity, and the answer is?
I think they heard
diversity, that. Very good. This is our test to make sure the audience is awake for our next main speaker here. What we want to do that is just quickly cover a little bit of our HOLA, our Hispanic Organization for Leadership and Achievement. That's what HOLA means for Johnson & Johnson. So we'll go quickly, and then we'll turn that over for the main event of the evening.
So everything we do here at J&J, for those of us who work here, it's based on our credo, and there are four tenets to it, but the three that we'll focus on today to really drive the message is it's always about the people we serve in our bit, and it's the doctors, the nurses, the patients, the mothers and our fathers and our products that end up being at the end of the day. We feel that if we do that first and foremost, it really is the essence of why we're here. To ensure that that does happen, our next major focus is always around our employees. So climbing a corporate ladder is very much in that tenet for us and in all of it, in our employees. And at the end it's serving our community. And this is actually one of the activities that we enjoy. And this is the second time we've been around, or I've been in the Shimba activity here at J&J. So to see how we get back, how we engage, how we partner with our communities and our local areas. And those are tenets that we live in all of through our marketplace, our people, and our communities.
And very much our strategic objective are built around the credo. And, you know, we can provide that, you know, at some other time. And but, you know, that's very much how we followed the guiding principle for our HOLA ERG. Just want to quickly go over the history of our ERG in Johnson & Johnson. It happened to be on 2001, five women founded the HOLA grassroots organization. And I had the pleasure to be around the five women. It tends to be that I'm always around women. I have three at home. I never get to say what I want, but you know, I'm happy living.
The statistics show that that would happen.
So they really created the energy to build the organization, and as you can see, you know, it's been a long journey, you know, across the different years.